Hey, what's up everyone, it's RoboDraws here with another video. Today I'm gonna tell you guys, in my opinion, the top 10 worst quests in the game. Some of these quests will be in old school and RS3, some of them will only be in RS3. So mainly this is about RS3, so I did every single quest in the game. And now I'm gonna talk about the top 10 worst quests in my opinion. Also, if you want to see in the future more like these videos, please leave a like and let me know in the comments, like if you want top 10 best quest of best quest series or something else RuneScape related. Let me know and then maybe I can make it happen. But without further ado, let's start with this countdown with number 10. Firemaker's Curse, also known with the quote, "Can you make it out alive?" So, this is, I think, something from the Mirror Rat series, because there is actually one Mirror Rat that follows, I think, Zaros or Zenrock, one of those two. But the quest itself, basically, you're gonna help a group of people to explore a cave. But when you're in the cave, you fall in some sort of trap and you need to do some puzzles. And you got like 7 or 8 rooms. And every time you need to complete the puzzle. But the good point is, they aren't that hard, so they are pretty easy to slow, but it isn't really fun, it isn't really nice to do. It's a bit annoying. At the end you got some boss fights. Also, the boss fight is nothing special, not something to look forward to. It's a bit, it's okay, but not that special. I think the quest is just too long. If it was shorter, maybe it shouldn't be on the list, but it's a bit too long and it's just very the same thing over and over again. The puzzle, sometimes you get an extra qualifier to get in a bit harder, but if you're not going for Questscape and don't really need any fire making XP, because the fire making XP you get from it is pretty good, you should avoid this quest, because it is not very much to it. I don't think you need it for anything. I think you can do the World Wakes without it. But Ritual of the Marriott or Gutic Sleeps, for one of them, I'm not sure you might need the quest though. Only, just it isn't that much fun, so. Anyways, let's go to number 8. Yeah. Underground Pass. To be honest, do I really need to talk about this quest in general? Because if you would look to people and ask, hey, what's your most hated quest? People are going, this quest will come there a couple of times. Just for multiple reasons already. To be honest, the first thing, the rewards aren't that good. The only good thing is maybe Ivan's staff. But the worst part is, like, you need 50 agility and 50 thieving to start. Alright, that's not that bad, alright. But the problem is, it's smarter to have an agility level way higher than that. Because if you can fall into traps and stuff, how lower your thieving is, how more damage you get. How lower your agility is, how more chances you have to fail. It's not an agility course, it's a freaking quest. To be honest, this quest is way too long. It makes absolutely no sense. You need to go all the way to this stupid cave. That's pretty long actually. It's for me a long time ago I did this quest, but To be honest, I don't think I will do this quest ever again. Unless maybe I have a really high thief and guilty levels, but then if I don't go on a quest again on Iron Man or something like that, why would I actually do this quest? It's only good for, yeah, to complete it and do the other quests you need for it. That's also the only reason I can see why you should do this quest. So it's just an annoying quest, and everyone, almost everyone, hates it. So just let's go to number 8, because I don't want to talk anymore about the Underground Pass. Alright, Do No Evil. To be honest, when I started this quest, I didn't really hate it that much. Until at a certain point in the quest, I was just bored. I was just done with it. I just wanted to stop with the quest, because I was bored. The quest is way too long. And to start with the worst part, maybe, it's when you got those three monkeys on Apa Making, the Monkey Madness Island, and you need to lure them out of this land. But first you need to do a stupid banana puzzle to lure a monkey god to a full crate with bananas, so you got the time for it. And that puzzle is maybe the worst part of the entire quest. So you don't see the puzzle here, because yeah, you had actually not released to get a picture of, because basically what you had to do, you had to drop bananas in his way of sight, so he would walk to them, then do the next, then do the next. But the problem is, you need to do it fast and not too far away, or he won't walk to it. And he eat them pretty fast, so basically you need to do it perfectly and fast as well. Like, you can't wait 10 seconds when he's walking, or you need to start over again because you're not fast enough. That's really annoying. But for the rest, so once you're in the desert and got everything sorted out, you think like, I'm done. So you go back to the pyramid and talk to, I can't get on the name, but anyways, you talk to the quest starting point, and then I sense that there's something wrong. You go back, hey, no one is here, and I see that core, that monkeys. So there is a ghost monkey, you talk to it, and guess what? Yep, they have been kidnapped and the rest was killed. Then you need to fight three golems, get them back, and then you finally done. To be honest, this quest, it was just way too long. That was the whole, what, everything that's one, what it, oh my god, I just can't get out of my words. But what was wrong with it? It was way too long. Just to keep it short, it was just way too long, and the puzzle was annoying. That's how I'm gonna say it in short terms. So let's go to number 7. Yeah, Rat Catchers. Well, you might see you are all worded with access to rat pits. Yes, rat pits. Rat pits. That's the entire problem. This quest gives you access to a mini game that's straight up dead. It's even stopped. So if you go to the RuneScape wiki, even it would say the rat pits were made inaccessible on 11th of April 2016 during the supposedly poor quality of the content, while the outdoor ones were completely removed. Yeah. Indeed, completely removed. Uh, And yeah, your cat could die in the minigame. I never played the minigame, so I basically can't talk about it. But the point is, the minigame is deleted out of the game. That's basically how bad it was. Also, you need to fight a very big mouse with your cat. And that's actually not easy. You better bring a lot of food if you're lucky enough to hit the rat, actually. And yeah, you better have not just a kitten, because that's even harder. Almost impossible. To be honest, the rewards are pretty lame. So you get 4,500 Thieving XP, 2 quest points, access to a dead minigame that you probably can't even play. Maybe in old school, I'm not sure about that one. And you unlock Willy and Lazy Cat. Willy and Lazy Cats. Well, it's a dead minigame. What can you say more about a quest that gives access to a minigame that's already dead? Really? This quest actually makes no sense anymore. And that's definitely one on the list. So let's go to number 6. Yeah. Do I need to say more than one small favor? Yes. Alright. Even if you say no, I was gonna tell it anyways. But the problem is with this quest, it's not one small favor. It starts with one small favor. After that, it's another small favor, and another one, and another one, and another one, and the other one, and that keeps on going for a while. So yes, this quest, I'm gonna say it very simple, but I'm not even kidding about it, because basically what you do is you talk to one guy, hey, I want that, can you get it? Alright, then you go to the next guy, hey, I want that, do you got that? Yes, I got it, but I want something in return. Okay, what you want? Yeah, you got that and that. So you go to another guy that had that item, he say, yeah, I have it, but I want that. And then you go to the other guy, and you that keeps on going. Honestly, that's all, everything you do in this quest. Like, alright, talk to that guy for that item. Hey, I can't get it, hey, I need to give him that. And that keeps on going. I don't hope there's ever gonna be a one small favor too. Because I'm not sure I will do it then. But hey, it's only at number 6, so hey, the Aquisitor even worse, yes. Unfortunately, yes. So let's go to number 5. Yeah. Silkus Endgame. Alright, first of all, I want to say I liked the God series quests. Until I did Silkus Endgame. Okay, so to be honest, you fight the gate. How does this quest start? Well, alright, you get an invitation randomly, okay. And you go to Draenor and talk to Rim. Yeah, I'm not actually don't know her name. But actually, the Silkus faction Tin. No idea why all those Tins are in the game, but anyways. You talk to her and say, yeah, you have been invited to Silkus game. Then you need to invite the gods. So you go, you ask Saradomin to join, Zamorok, Armadale, yeah, not Bandos, because Bandos is dead. Yeah, that's just how it is. And then Saren and Zeros. And also you need to get that and Itlirin or something like that. I can't say his name correctly, but sorry for that. Anyways, then you go to Gotwas 2, Heart of Gilinor, and you have to fight Nomad once again, but that's a very straightforward fight. Not too much. But after that, Then begins why this quest is on the list. It's a maze. Not just a maze. You just need to walk through the maze. And wow, it doesn't sound that hard, but no. You need to go in multiple rooms, do a stupid simple puzzle in the room, walk again through the maze, walk again, keep walking to the next room, and then suddenly you can go to a portal, and then you get in the next section, do the same thing. Well, actually, you are longer in the maze than you do in anything else in this quest. The maze is longer than the actually fights, starting anything, everything. I hated this maze so much that after this game, yeah, this quest is one of the worst quests I ever did. I mean, I can give them credit for the fight scenes after the maze, because the fights were pretty sick and you could finally kill off Sliske, but is that really something to just say the quest was good? In my opinion, not. Challenging? Yes, but the maze was also a bit challenging, but that was in not a good way. So yeah, without the quest, without the maze, the quest will be too short, I think. And not make that much sense either. So actually the point is, you need to go to a maze, the two winners, and will be you and another god, need to race to get the Stone of Yes. The winner gets it, but no, they actually don't get it, because the Stone of Yes gets destroyed by the Dragonkins that Sliske invited himself to mix things up. Anything good? No, this quest was just horrible. The maze just made this quest no fun and destroyed all fun in this quest for me. The fight made a bit up for it, but not even a bit if you compare it with the maze. But hey, let's go to number 4. Yeah, Morin's End Part 2. Yeah, maybe you heard many people talk about this quest as well by the worst quests. And I can't say that they are not right, because this quest sucks. So you need to get some mirrors, and then with the lasers, so you can go to the next room, and then the next room to unlock. I can't say much about it, to be honest, so I'm sorry about that, but this quest is just horrible, man. I mean, alright, the chance you will do it is very high, so you can unlock Prithendis, the Elven Land, that's really good for skilling and everything. But this quest, I mean, the final quest is Plague's End. Alright, I think I said it right. But the point is, that quest is okay. Alright, it's not too bad. But the Morning's End Part 2, it sucks ass. Okay, Part 1 was bad, but it was okay. I mean, it wasn't that long as this one. So, yeah, you don't win it, alright, I did it. Wait, there's a part 2? You kidding me? Oh my god, yeah. So then you need to, actually, full time you in this sort of temple of light. Place in mirrors, replace in mirrors, remove in mirrors, the entire time. It's a big puzzle with mirrors. It's basically not worth your time. I mean, also you can get attacked by things in the temple, that makes it a bit more annoying. But about things attacking you during a quest, No, that's more something you would see at the next entry on the list, so you know what, I'm just going to there. Yeah, Darkness of Hollowville. I'm not kidding. This quest is not hard, but it's annoying as hell. So, let me explain it. So, you know the Vampire Quest series? Well, if you don't know it, first of all, you start helping out the city, making it back to a city. Because it was destroyed by the vampires, the people living there were also not, yeah, also hunted by the vampires, kinda. People were basically disappearing because of because of the vampires. Yeah, they were like vire watches. Vires, not really vampires. It's not something like in Draenor Manor with that weak counter Draenor, it's very easy to kill. Anyways, you need to go to the city where those vampires rule. But you need to do, this is like an entire maze, the city. So you might think, if you didn't do this quest yet, alright, but why is this on the list and not further entries? Well, further entries makes it a lot easier. Because for the last quest, you get a medallion and you just teleport basically to the castle. And that plays the entire quest. And believe me, that doesn't suck even close as this. Are the quests good? Actually, yes. Later on, they are pretty good. Actually, the final boss fight is also challenging. But, man, this quest? Well, if it was just a random quest, nobody would even do it because it's just stupid. Because you need to climb to houses, climb to windows, climb up ladders, sprint from roof to roof, and not the one roof because then you are lost in the maze again and again and again. Also, to the hideout constantly. Hey, you need to go back to the hideout. Okay, let's go. Normally, you need to get caught by a vile watch that sometimes take a couple of minutes. And then, no, send me to the mines. And then, just mine. You have to mine a little bit. Get out. Then, do as you can see on the second page, go that way to go to the base again. So, we could hide out in the city. Yeah. It's not worth. It's just not worth it. I just hated the quest so much. Actually, let's go on to number two. Quests that even suck more than this one. Yeah. Elemental Workshop 3. First of all elemental workshops suck. But this one is the worst. I was stuck on this quest almost at the end. So the land is moderate to long. Well, it wasn't moderate for me. Also not long, but very long. Oh yeah, very long. I think it was maybe a bit more than 1 hour. But I did everything like Quest Scout said, and I still managed to screw it up. And I couldn't get it back to normal, so in the end I just was pushing some random buttons, and in the end I managed to complete it. You also have a follow-up called Elemental Workshop 4. I mean, it also don't make any sense, but it's not as bad as this quest. Well, if you don't go for Questscape, you have no clue to start even Elemental Workshop 1 or to do any of the Elemental Workshops. Because I think the only need thing you need the Elemental Workshop for is for the next and the next and the next. And to be honest, the rewards are terrible. 50 gold, 2000 smitten XP, an XP dump. Yeah. You wanna know how much XP the XP dump is? Alright. Yeah, it's actually not that good. Alright, here it comes. Two charges. Of 4250 defense XP or 3250 smitten XP. Wow. That's really why you want to do it. Honestly, the 50 gold you can just mine. Do we almost element the workshop one? It's just stupid. Element the workshop 2, same story. The element the workshop 3, it's the worst quest ever. Almost. There's one quest worse, but at least the quest without box. So actually let's just go to number one, because this quest is just insanely stupid. So that's a quick summary about this. Just a stupid quest. Stupid puzzle that's way too confusing sometimes. And yeah, no fun at all. And no sense. So for number one, let's go to what we had. Number 10, the Firemaker's Curse. Number 9, Underground Pass. Number 8, Do No Evil. Number 7, Rat Catches. Number 6, Once More Favor. Number 5, Slisk's Endgame. Number 4, Mornings and Part 2. Number 3, Darkness of Hollowville. Then number 2, Elemental Workshop 1. It's time for number 1, guys. Here we go. South in the Wound. Alright. This quest sucks so much just because one big reason. Box. This quest is tested worst controls in the game. Because you basically need to control three other characters. You start actually at dungeoneering. Okay, not too bad. You go in a dungeon, need to do get something. No problems there. But it all starts when you enter the cave where you need to fight the Slug Queen. You need to control, but sometimes when you pick out the character, your camera goes like so strange that you click somewhere you don't want to go, and then you go the character walks out that way. No, and the scenario want to go that way. The controls are so terrible that the whole quest is just a mess. Maybe it's a bit better now than back when I did it, but I hardly doubt it. I think it's better than it was on release, for sure. At least I hope. Because, yeah, it's even probably worse than when I did it. So, you have other quests where you control other characters, but they were all okay. They were not that bad. The controls were actually decent. And no, you don't fight the queen, no. Why would you fight the queen? No. You need to control the other characters to walk around, because you can't confront the queen because some people block you. And you need to walk around and basically let a boulder, a big, very big boulder, fall on the queen. So it's that. Hey, that's easy. Yeah. Just don't do the quest if you don't want Questscape. It's the final of the Slug series. The rerods are okay this time around, so that's something, but yeah. Also, it don't make any sense, because in the beginning the quest is like in the quest before, Kenneth is still a kid, and later Kenneth is grown up in this quest, so it also don't make any sense with aging in RuneScape. But just let get that out of the way and just let add this, because South in the Wound is not a fun quest. So if you enjoyed this video, be sure to leave a like down there. subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. I really would appreciate if you do. I upload multiple, I have a lot of videos already uploaded on my channel. If you really have nothing to do, check them out. I also really appreciate if you do that. And as always, if you survive to the end of the video, that I highly doubt. Thanks for watching and see you guys next time. Bye guys.